Ray Bourque came on the scene at a time when he was in the unenviable position of skating in the blade trails of Bobby Orr.
From 1966 to 1976, legendary defenseman Bobby Orr delighted Boston Bruins fans, winning 8 Norris trophies and bringing 2 Stanley Cups to the city. In 1979, 3 years after his departure, the Bruins drafted Montreal native Ray Bourque 8th overall, anticipating he would be Orr's successor.
They saw this young 18-year-old come and put up numbers and stuff, so it was kind of a normal thing for them to be kind of thinking that way, but there's no way that anybody was going to come along and be another Bobby Orr. So if I could only be the half the player that Bobby Orr was, I think I'd be a pretty good NHL player.
Bourque thrilled. He won the Calder Trophy as top rookie in his first season. His exceptionally accurate shot allowed him to be a steady goal scorer throughout his career, scoring double-digit goals in 21 of his 22 seasons. His shot was so accurate, in fact, he won the All-Star Games shooting accuracy competition 8 times. A 19-time All-Star, he was also one of the greatest defensively.
Ray Bourque was the strongest player I ever played against. Once he hit you, it's a brick wall. He would not budge, and you would budge a lot.
The Bruins fan favorite won the Norris Trophy 5 times. Only 3 players have won it more.
Ray had that aura about him. He wasn't just another defenseman. He was special.
I don't think there was ever a player that I played with that enjoyed the game as much as Raymond.
Bourque's appreciation for the game and the fans' respect for him went well beyond his on-ice play. And this was exemplified in December 1987 when the Bruins retired Phil Esposito's number 7.
Ray Bourque, the captain of the Bruins, will make a presentation.
Probably the greatest non-playing highlight in Bruins history.
Look at that.
Oh, wow!
Oh, my goodness.
What a moment!
I think it was just perfect. The number should be up there.
It cemented Ray's place in the iconography of Bruins and Boston sports history.
The revered captain performed at an elite level for over 20 seasons with the Bruins. He led them to the Stanley Cup final twice, but suffered defeat both times. With the Bruins out of playoff contention late in the 1999-2000 season, they traded Bourque to the Colorado Avalanche, where he would have a chance to win the Stanley Cup he still was pursuing.
Our team was not in a position to contend for the Stanley Cup at that time, and he deserved that opportunity.
In 2000-2001, his final season, it all came down to the ultimate game.
Game 7 of the Stanley Cup Final. Will Ray Bourque finally get to hoist Lord Stanley's Cup?
The fans, the building was going nuts.
30 seconds left to go.
I thought I would pass out because I had a hard time breathing.
10 seconds left to go.
I'd try to get off. The guys would push me back on the ice. They wanted me to be out there for the final buzzer.
To win the Stanley Cup, Raymond Bourque, a dream come true.
It was an incredible experience when it was all over with, and just an incredible relief.
Joe Sakic immediately turned and handed to Ray Bourque, who lifted up and over his head. Ray Bourque, 22 years, has waited for this moment.
He's an icon of the game, and he wanted to win that cup so bad, and just felt it was the right thing to do.
Anyone who ever met Ray Bourque walked away saying, this is just a really good guy. And I think in our game, whether the player is on your team or the other team, if you recognize that he's a good person, then you cheer for him.
You don't deserve to win the cup, but when you play as long and hard and great as Ray Bourque does, there comes a point when you deserve to win the cup, and I was just so happy for him.
22 years and trying to accomplish that was just phenomenal, knowing that that's the way I was going to walk out.
Bourque retired following that season as the NHL's career leader in goals, assists, and points by a defenseman. And though he won his Stanley Cup in Colorado, forever a Bruin, Boston honored his achievement, hosting him and the Cup.
This is unbelievable.
I was fortunate to play till I was 40 years old, 22 years, and had an incredible time, and I lived the dream. I was so blessed.